In this video, we will show you how to map NGS data against a reference sequence using the Map to Reference tool in Geneious. We are working with a dataset of trimmed Illumina sequence reads, which map to a single gene in the E. coli genome. Select the file of trimmed reads and the reference sequence, and click Align, Assemble, and Map to Reference. Reset to the default settings using the gear at the bottom left of the window. Geneious Prime will guess which of the sequences you have selected is the reference, but you can change this using the drop-down menu. In this case, it is chosen correctly, and YGHJ-CDS Divergent Reference should be chosen as the reference sequence. Note that the reference sequence does not have to be pre-selected before opening the Map to Reference window. Instead, it can be selected from any folder in your database by clicking the Choose button within the Setup options. This option will also allow you to select multiple reference sequences, or sequences from another folder. In the Method panel, select Geneious as the mapper. A number of different mapping algorithms are available here, and these have varying strengths and weaknesses depending on the type of data you are assembling. A brief outline of the different algorithms available is shown in the tutorial section of our website. Geneious will automatically choose an appropriate sensitivity based on the size of your dataset. In this case, the sensitivity is set on medium sensitivity / fast. For next generation sequencing, medium or medium low sensitivity is recommended, as using high sensitivity will take a long time and is unlikely to improve the results if you have sufficient coverage. The fine-tuning option can improve the results by aligning reads to each other in addition to the reference sequence. Set this on Iterate up to 5 times. Ensure Do Not Trim is selected, and under the Results panel, choose Save Assembly Report and Save Contigs, but uncheck Save in Folder if this is selected. Your Map to Reference options should now look like this. Click OK to run the assembly. Two new documents should now be created in your document table, a contig of the reads mapped to the reference, and an assembly report. Click on the contig to view the reads mapped to the reference sequence. Open the assembly report and you will see how many reads were assembled, how long it took, and what contigs were produced. Visit our Resource Center for more hands-on exercises and tutorials.